Hey guys, before we get to the video, please click that subscribe button. Thank you.
Hey guys, Joshua Griffin Air serving the Middle Peninsula and the Northern Neck of Virginia, and wanted to do a video. I actually had a question on my website, newhvacguide.com, and one of our customers was asking something to the effect of, what is a TXV, and, do I need it, and so on. And to give a little backstory, apparently one of the quotes he got when he was getting quotes to replace his heating and air conditioning system, they were asking him if he wanted the TXV because they were giving him the either or option and, trying to upsell him, I guess. Hey, I also wanted to insert that if you have a contractor asking you if you want the TXV installed, that's a weird question, to be honest with you. I've never asked someone if they wanted it installed. Either a system's gonna work better or it's not with the TXV. And in most cases, it is. So I just think it's a little weird if you're even asked that. Just wanted to throw that in there. I'm not gonna get into all the ins and outs of how a TXV works and all that. There's videos from people way smarter than me on YouTube that they'll go through that. But I wanted to do a video, an overall bird's eye view of the situation and what you need to know as a homeowner. Ultimately, air conditioning systems have what we call a metering device, at each of the coils. And in the old days, it used to be just a piston, what we call a piston or an orifice, and it would basically give the refrigerant just a smaller hole, and it would restrict it enough to where it would do what it needs to do. And as time went on, they came out with thermal expansion valves, and there's even today, now there's electronic expansion valves and things like that. And the main thing you need to know as a homeowner is these valves, they'll open and close based on the temperature or they'll change as they need to. When we had pistons, that was not an option. They were what they were. The problem with that though is situations and, the atmosphere and things like that will change. As your air filter gets dirtier, as your evaporator coil gets dirtier, as they get cleaned and things like that, the system can operate differently. It'll give you different pressures and things like that. So if we connect our gauges, sometimes we might get one side or the other might be high or low based on the situation that it's in, low airflow or high airflow or whatever, that's the whole deal here. And so a thermal expansion valve can, open and close based on what it's needing. And obviously if it gets like significantly low in refrigerant, then, there are situations where, it can't do what it needs to do and we have to get involved. But ultimately, what I wanted to just do this video on is just to say, if you have a company that's giving you an either or option, I would say go with the thermal expansion valve. If they're a good reputable company and they do all the brazing techniques like they're supposed to, you have nothing to worry about as far as, the TXV. There was a point in time where they were having some trouble with some of the oils that were being put in some of the compressors and it was gumming up the TXVs and all this stuff. And those days are over. So go with the TXV in most cases. In a lot of cases, it will make the system more efficient. So you might have a system that is a 13 SEER or 14 SEER, and it'll go up to a 14 or 15 SEER just by adding the TXV. Last thing I'll say, don't be afraid to ask questions. If your contractor is proposing something like that, find out the pros and cons to whatever it is they're proposing. So if they're like, well, we can add this or that or whatever. Years ago, we had a brand, Ameristar, that is owned by Trane, American Standard, and Ingersoll Rand and all that. And they were getting the air handlers made in China by Midea. And the problem was some of the pistons would get stuck. So they're supposed to shift back and forth depending on what mode they're in. And You know, some brands pistons were great. You know, they were, especially back in the R22 days, they, you know, they were great. But with this particular brand, the way the pistons were made, sometimes they would get stuck or they wouldn't shift like they were supposed to. And so we would add a TXV, and we basically got to a point where after we had installed a few of them, we would just always do the TXV. You know, we'd always install that just to, you know, to alleviate all of those issues. So in short, if you're just watching this, if somebody has proposed TXV or, you know, thermal expansion valve or whatever, I would say you definitely need to, you know, have it installed properly. But I would say between the two, piston or TXV, these days, especially with 410A refrigerant, TXV is the way to go. 410A is not as forgiving as R22 was. R22, I remember working with some guys that they would just put their hand on the line and be like, oh, that's beer can cold, that's good, and they would just leave it. But those days are over. With 410A, it's not as forgiving. It's got to be dead on. And with the TXV, you do a subcool measurement, you get that thing dialed in perfectly, and that system will run great. So anyway, I hope this helps. If you have any questions or anything like that, feel free to comment below. If you're in our coverage area, Griffin Air, in the Middle Peninsula or the Northern Neck of Virginia, we'd love to earn your business. And if you're not in our coverage area, but you're in the market for a new heating and air system, before you spend thousands, you gotta check out my website, newhvacguide.com. I'll put a link to it down in the notes, but you got to check out this website. I've put so much information on there. There's stuff on there that heating and air contractors and manufacturers don't even want you to know. And we even have a whole page called no-nos, you know, things to stay away from. Check out that website before you spend thousands. Check out that website. And I really appreciate you watching. Please subscribe. Thank you.